Good morning and welcome to Y254 in the morning. Just in case you're joining us, it's WCW, a segment where we celebrate the strength of a woman. Keep engaging us on all our social media platforms at Y254 channel. Engage me at Faith Musoli across all my socials. And today in studio, we got a power woman, so selfless. A woman who has been a beacon of hope to so many teenage mothers out there. The founder of One Bra, One Girl. Her name is Rose Nyaboke. You're welcome.
Yeah, Rose Nyabate.
Nyabate, sorry.
Rose Nyabate. Okay. If I say Nyabate, my people will be very mad.
Yeah. Yes. I guess it. So, who is Rose Nyabate?
Rose Nyabate. I'm just Rose Nyabate. Mm-hmm. I don't know how I can describe myself.
Okay.
But it's just me.
Yeah, it's just you. But yes. What do you do apart from the foundation? Okay. What does Rose like doing?
Okay. Now, I'm called Rose Nyabate or Nyabate. I'm a social worker by profession. In school, I took social work. So, outside here, I came and ventured into media for a while because that's what I loved. So then out of that, out of the two, my passion and also the one I took in school, so I'm able to balance and all of them I'm practicing at the same time.
So you did journalism in school?
No. I wanted to do journalism, something weird is. I wanted at around the age of around five, I wanted to We did not even have a TV or a radio during those early years. So my mom was a hawker. These women on the road, we meet in the evening. So one day I told my mother, one day you'll see me on TV. My mom was just sitting there. She just laughed, looked at me and said, Wewe, of all the people, we don't even own a radio. It will never happen. So many years later, when I wanted to take journalism, my uncle was the one sponsoring me. So I asked him if he could allow me. He told me, no, you are not beautiful. That career needs beautiful people. Choose another one. So since I also have passion in working with people, I say, let me take social work. Yes.
So you ventured into social work in school?
Yes. So I did in Kisumu Polytechnic. So I went because even initially before that, I was volunteering. I was exposed to these two NGO things when I was taken to a girls' health project that mentored me. So from around class 7 going up. So because of that kind of mentorship, you're being chosen leaders. So it prepared me to know what I will take.
Exactly.
Alternatively. Yes.
So what was the motive, what pushed you into starting the foundation of One Bra, One Girl?
Okay, One Girl, you call it One Girl, One Bra.
And why didn't you call it two Bra, One Girl?
Yeah, you asked me that. You see, what happened was, I told you I've been in the media for a while, for a long time. So there's I have my fan base. I used to be in classmates. So I have some fan base of my friends, and I normally engage them online at times. So during this time of Corona, I was working at a relative's hospital. I was just doing cleaning. We are those people who decided let us do anything to survive, to be alive. So then I was cleaning. I do cleaning in the morning. You know, cleaning done in the morning. So I was listening to the radio. Then I heard that Nikaskia was chana studio wangapi. That's the day where the statistics were coming. 3,000 girls pregnant. What? So people are talking. People are so mad about it. Then I remembered something. I remembered like, wait a minute. I was at that nimaikuwa hapo. Nimaikuoka hiyo miaka ya watoto. What made me nikapita? Then I remembered that time. Me around 13 years, I had big breast already. My breast, unless you know, we have different types of breast, of which so many people don't know. People just know breast that is standing and the one that is sleeping. They know and they make it as a joke. So I just remembered how at 13 I had breast. mm-hmm. big, and they were facing down eh? Mm-hmm. So and others in my class who some of us sisi wenye tulikuwa na bigger bust,
mm-hmm.
we used to be told to sit behind in the village eh? Mm-hmm. So sisi tunakaa nyuma, mm-hmm. we are the people who go to fetch water for teachers, mm-hmm. when the cooks are not around, you know, they prepare some rolls for us
with eh? The big girls.
Yeah, they even yes, that one. They even ask you, like me, they will ask me, I will transfer from one school to another, mm-hmm. because my uncle is a policeman, eh? The one mm-hmm. who was taking care of me during those times. Mm-hmm. So you will see, as I'm going, naulizwa, umacha wapi mtoto, umacha tini kubwa. So the people used to make a joke of me. Mm-hmm. I used to be a performer. I started going down. So at one point, when I was in class 8, now this story, mm-hmm. How this foundation started, mm-hmm. I was just remembering the whole thing. Mm-hmm. Nikaenda nikakachini, nikaandika, nikasema, by the way, there's a madam nikiwa class 8, mm-hmm. aliniita because the more unaendelea you want to hide, mm. I cannot tell my uncle I need a bra to ya kunisitiri, mm-hmm. so I started walking like this. By the time I'm in class 8, huku umeja nakaa hivi
nakaa mwanaume,
exactly, yeah. mwanaume must be that's what. So this madam called me, akanipea bra, akaniambia go put on this one, hafu akaniambia I want you to come, mm. utembee hivi
straight,
like, kama a lady.
Upright, yeah.
Yes. So vile alinifanya hivyo, akaniambia, it is normal. Now she started mentoring me, akaniambia it's normal. But you know boys huko ushago, even these funny, funny people in the village, walikuwa nakuita kuja, nini they think I'm niko ready.
Yes.
So my classmates, I know, nikiandika hiyo something in kwa article nikasema, mm. me want to use this bra. I want to use bra as a drive ya kufikia wasichana. Because how when you utapata majority wenye wametumika, wenye wamepata ball, those ones who are pregnant, eh? Mm. They become pregnant teen mothers. They are those ones. Mm-hmm. Those people, those ones that people think ni wamama kwa darasa.
Mm.
And you know that word, eh? Mm. Those ones are the ones who have been targeted. Now, how can I reach to them? How can I tell them you are beautiful? How can I restore their dignity? Mm. So I just wrote within no minute, it went. I can say it viral in a small way because it was shared so many groups. So people asking me, what can we do? Because me, I'd said, I'm going to give bras.
Mm-hmm.
And that all bras angu ndakuwa napea watu. Mm. So as I go, I talk to them. Since I'm a social worker, mm. I'm able to talk to them free of charge. So now that is how, my fan base, Facebook, mm-hmm. ndi walini sukuma. Mm-hmm. Well, in support, mm-hmm. I've never used a single cent that belongs to me.
The power of social media
and also grace.
Mm-hmm.
And we usually say, "Ati ojina one girl one bra."
Mm-hmm.
Ili ni kujia, nikambiwa tu. I want you to do this.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be one girl one bra. Mm-hmm. Every girl, mwenye hana anaweza pata. Mi madam alikuja akanipatia.
Mm.
So I said, I'm going to reach this type of people. Number mm-hmm. one, wasichana wa primary wenye wako na breast,
yeah.
Kubwa, mm. they are not able to afford. I can give them mentorship. Those ones who are already pregnant, now, we write them off.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we've mm-hmm. been writing these people off.
Mm-hmm.
Atukisha shika mimba, enda kwa mzee. You are at 16. Those mm. are the ones who are beaten nowadays.
Yeah.
Those are the ones when you end up in divorce, because you can imagine a 19-year-old boy
yeah.
with an 18-year-old girl,
mm-hmm.
they don't know what they are doing. So I said I'm going to reach to this type of people.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So, yes. I can imagine a 13-year-old.
Yes.
You're giving a 13-year-old a bra.
Yes.
At first, there is just this stigma, yeah? Mm. I'm young.
Yes.
You're giving me a bra, despite the fact I've got a big bust, mm. but there is this stigma, yeah? Siwezi vaa bra, you see?
Mm.
So, how do you convince them?
Actually, yeah. You see, like in the villages, they used to tell us, you are supposed to put on boobs. Boob, is it
boob? Boob tops. Yeah.
I used to look at that and I was like, no.
Uh-huh.
In the village, they say, when you put on bra,
uh-huh.
your breast in a
sag.
Those things are supposed to support you.
Yes.
That ni kama viatu.
Yes.
Viatu ukiva, ukikanyaga chini for long, mm-hmm. utapata viatu mgui na kaivi.
True.
So, what happens is, we teach them. Actually, mm-hmm. unajua kama 13, nowadays watoto wanakuwa kubwa.
Haraka.
Mm-hmm. We talk to them. Our main thing actually is to talk to them.
Mm-hmm.
Tambi, you know what, the way you are,
mm-hmm.
breast system, we have those ones that are round, We have those ones that are popo shaped, zile zinazene ziko zikienda chini. We have those ones that are athletics zinakaa athletic. Ile nyana kuanga ime, I don't want to use another word. Then you have those ones that are east and west, inangalianga huku. So vile huko, as you are growing, understand ni normal. Usi allow watu wa kushike-shike, kuna ile uchungu. Then we teach them about just breast health in general. Now, since I'm not an expert, a very good expert, now when it comes to medical, so now that is vile tunaanza ku-network. So like there's a time, ninaita wale wenye wako in charge of breast cancer. So they come, they tell them, ukisikia, wakati unaoga, wanafanya nini, you know those ones.
Yes.
So you find it inakava kila kitu.
Right.
Yes.
So you give the bras to each and every girl, or you just selectively like?
Yes.
The ones who already have a big bust, or you just give to any girl who is above 13 years?
Now, what's happening is, it now depends. You see, like, in a school,
because in most cases it does not speak like I'm coming tomorrow, you just wake
it does
up.
Not
yes
yeah,
to
yeah.
some people yes. it's just like from nowhere
unapata imekuja.
Yes.
you see now we are growing. I told you this is something that I'm not funded any agency is not funding me. It's people like even now the project I'm going to do, it's my classmate, my class one classmate. Somebody I studied with in 1996. And I think we separated around 98, when my mom passed on. So he was the prefect and I was a monitor. So like, he has come up, he's given me more than 200 brands to go and distribute. Now what I do select. We go like, now we are going to a school, they gave birth, they are back in school. So if there are 100, each of them has to get it. Because you'll find like even in the slums where we've been going like I've gone to, mostly I'm in Kajiado, although I go to other places. Unapata a lady anasema, I'm a single mother, I'm 17. I have a baby here. Am I supposed to, between buying a bra and buying food for my child,
yes.
what am I supposed to do? I buy food because that is what my child depends on. So we give them just one or two. Actually, we normally say it's one girl, one bra, but we find you will get even two.
Yes.
And we have a variety, those book top, those sports bras. So all of them, yes. We give all of them. So unakuja na pikenya ina unaweza. But you are doing selection with time. We'll be targeting a particular. And we are doing trainings. So like in school, we'll be taking, we are going to take peer supporters or peer educators. So like if you know you are in class 7, you are endowed, you can talk to another person, you will be our representative. So we talk, we give what we'll give to you. Then we tell you, ukienda huko, ongelesha wengine. Mwambie it's normal. We don't have to have, in fact, at the end of the day,
this is what because of the stigma of just putting on a bra. Leave alone the stigma of having the breast.
Yes, yes. But you know, another thing is, nobody will undress you.
Exactly.
Nobody will undress you.
True.
You just put it on and you look beautiful. So now that is one thing. Because, you know, from my psychology part of it, I'm not so good at it because people can attack me. Is if you tell somebody you are beautiful, as a mother, if you're a mother, you tell your son, you are beautiful, you are handsome, sorry, you look good, or a father can be a mtoto wake, my daughter, you are beautiful. If she meets another man, amwambie you are beautiful, I already know.
True.
My father told me.
Exactly.
You understand? Like myself, in my situation, I lost my parents at a very early age. My mother never lived to see me on TV, by the way. She never lived to see, and this is one thing that I really feel. So, I normally feel.
Sorry.
Yeah, it's all right. I don't know, I used to tell her that KBC is in London. I'll tell her, you know what? I will be in KBC in London. Those were the days. But then my dreams came true because I've been in your sister station for a while.
And you're here, even if you're not a journalist, but you're here on TV.
Yes, and I've been working in one of the biggest media house in Kenya for a while.
Okay.
But that was out of determination. So I don't call myself an orphan, but I was once an orphan. I could not sikuwa napata any basics also that's another thing ukiona I'm giving out the little I have want to reach to people somebody was asking why do you give at times when you don't have
exactly
do you give?
Like so because what's the drive
is this when my mother went passed on I went through and the hands of guardians you understand the guardian and I appreciate them one thing I usually say as before I even say the whole thing mean I appreciate them because at least they stood to be counted but now there are those things that sikuwa napata unapata I lack basics now I'm at, in my adolescence I was living in a police station I'm living with a man
you're having periods you're using a blanket
and no I didn't use a blanket per se but but I don't want to say who gave me the first the, pad that one will be another story for another time but now I needed a woman figure you know the camp police camp everybody's a man my guardian is also a man alafu yako na other business we have those people I think he believed alafu again he saw me with big breast he was asking me wewe wezi angalia unakata 40 na watu wengine so like to me what happened was adolescence ikanipeleka mbio sana I wrote an article the other day it's on my Facebook adolescence was taking me minanipeleka mbio
so
you understand my breast are big unapata but I want to say that those people that you are living it in the camp, they never exploited me. That one I'll say. They were, in fact, they were really the ones who used to protect me also. So, but life in Anpeleka Mbiu, I don't know, you know, hormones in a rage. Now, community, I went to the church. Kuna siku emotions ilinipeleka, si leo nini nitendekea. My uncle told me, sorry, my uncle, sorry. He told me, you know, wewe, utashika mimba wewe. He could remind me every time nikifanya makosa kidogo ananikumbusha shika tu mimba you'll be pregnant and you'll go like sijui whatever something like that and you know he kept saying and in our community where we come from in Africa when your relative sees utafanya ni kama anakulaani so I was wondering then I remembered my own sister after my mom passed she became a teen mother and then I remembered my mother gave birth at around 14. So nikaona my uncle what he could be telling me is that he's seeing the cycle repeating itself. So this time I'm seated in the house alone because he could leave me alone for a while kwa muda mrefu sana. So nimekaa kwa nyumba najiambia I want to break this cycle of being a teen mother. Kwa sababu alikuwa ananiambia utaolewa, uolewe na mtu anakunywa bangi, mlevi atakuwa anakupiga, you know those kind of thing. So he's creating from the age of around 12, 13. Yani
and to make it worse, you already have a big burst. So you kind of like you're already a mother.
I was not loving myself. Because ile mtu anakuambia I didn't love myself trust me nile tu I just think God aliniweka in position Mungu aliniweka mahali because maybe he had a plan that I one day I reach to people but I can tell you I didn't love myself bila aliniambia hivyo nikatoka nikaenda kwa kulikuwa na crusade fulani kwa nini police line nikasikia siku moja nikamkata siku nikasikia roho ni ngumu so nikajiuliza what can I do and I'm around class 7 so nikasikia crusade nje tu me am an SDA I don't know this sijuangi a lot nikaenda pale I know I told myself God you know what I want to argue with you I want to argue my case with you God I don't want to get a husband
and at that time you are in class 7.
Yes. And you know how old I was. So nikapiga magoti chini. Kitu kaniambia you know. Huyu God. Ataona kama uko serious. Go to that crusade. You know he's there. So ukiwa there argue your case. You may find someone who can help you pray even if it's the whatever. Why you know that? Because something was heavy in me. Ilikuwa ananiambia Rose you're not going to be. You know,
to be pregnant
something weird. The first time my mother took me to school, nursery, 95. As she was leaving, aliniambia, my daughter unajua nilifika class 3. Nataka ukisoma, unisomee pia. Finish where I left. Mienda sijui kuandika, sijui kizungu. So I want you to learn English. So my sister is here also.
She wanted you to achieve
her dreams. My mother wanted to achieve her dreams. Then here, I'm reminded I'm going to be a teen mother. So and hizo ndio vitu zenye zinafanya pia nakuwa na passion. Okay, I went to that church. I sat down. I could not pray, so I decided to tell God, you know what? You have to fight for me. let us fight this. And by the time I left there, Missy Kwaikwa na yo wherever. So immediately, uh-huh. a teacher from another school, uh-huh. aka request my uncle nikakuwa transferred. Community around, this is a parent who akanipatia manguo, mwingine mafuta, mwingine lunch program.
Awesome.
Mimi a community fought for me. So when you see me trying, fighting for others, however little it is, I just want people to look at me and know they can make it. Kama umeza, I know my sister Aliza. No,
mm-hmm.
I'm sure mama angu kama angepata second chance. Okay, mm-hmm. you know, another thing is, you know, my mother was killed. Eh?
Mm-hmm.
She died at a very young age mm-hmm. because, yeah. So ninakaa najiuliza, mama angu angepata second chance,
mm-hmm.
ambiurudi back to school, she would have been better.
True.
She would have been the one talking here
mm-hmm.
because me and her, we are the same person.
Exactly.
So if she will have been given a chance, so may I want to reach sing our mother when you're standing on your meshaza, you are not a reject. You deserve a second chance.
Awesome.
And you will have you want to break that circle
mm-hmm.
cycle. So when I give you a bra, I'm giving you knowing that is symbolic. You look at that bra and know that you are beautiful.
Awesome.
And you deserve a second chance.
Awesome.
Kama mtoto wako ameshika mimba, mwambie azae.
Mm-hmm.
Don't force them to go to somebody mwenye. Because myself, community fought for me. Ilikuwa sina hata hiyo
bill. So you're kind of giving back. You're kind of giving back to the society because of what the community did to you.
Yes. And I just, I'm compelled. And the kind of satisfaction I get
mm-hmm.
when I see somebody saying thank you. When I see somebody anavana, anasikia vizuri, afu unajua, hata kumongelesha. Unajua kitu important sana ni kuongelesha mtu.
Mm-hmm.
Ile na mongelesha mtu, ananiambia, you know what, I understand. Like there's a place we went, you know, like if I go to places, I go with other various people.
Mm-hmm.
Like I have, tunezenda tuonge mambo ya mental health, nini.
Mm-hmm.
We went somewhere, I took a lady who went through domestic violence.
Mm-hmm.
Akenda kaongelesha wasichana, teen mothers, in a particular forum that we were.
Mm-hmm.
I saw a girl in the crowd crying.
Mm-hmm.
She cried. Came and hugged the speaker that he had come with.
Mm-hmm.
Then akamwambia, me have been hurt.
Mm-hmm.
So when you see such things, zinafanya nasikia vizuri sana.
Mm-hmm.
Because aliona, she has been hurt.
Mm-hmm.
Ameona there's another lady ame make it.
Mm-hmm.
So when a girl akiniangalia ajue, Rose was alone. Rose amefika hapa.
Mm-hmm.
So that one enough. I'm very happy.
True.
Yes.
And so speaking of mental health, have you met these girls, young girls, teenage girls,
yes,
who they are growing, they are developing, but they just don't know what's happening in their body.
Yes.
And then they are so much disturbed, like what's happening. Because in most cases you find that sio kila mtoto huongeleshwa kwamba when you reach such a certain age, these are the changes you'll see in your body. Have you met these teenage girls who are disturbed by the physical changes in their body?
Yeah, I've met them.
Mm-hmm.
And I've met them and I tell them, you know what?
Mm-hmm.
Sai ni vile I'm proportional.
Mm-hmm.
My body's proportional. Maybe you look and say, oh, I'm like proportional.
Mm-hmm.
There was a time people will say, ule msichana mwenye anakuanga na matiti kubwa. Now that is how people used to know me. Even in college, people will use that as a symbol.
Uh-huh.
Because, so I'll tell them, you know what?
Mm.
We go, we talk.
Mm.
Unajua, when you take mtu mwenye amego through that,
mm-hmm.
unamuonyesha, somebody who has been hurt,
mm-hmm.
will show another person who is hurt that it's well.
Yes.
So I've seen them,
mm-hmm.
and I want to reach to many of them.
Mm-hmm.
Niwambi, it's normal, and it's very normal. And don't stigmatize your children.
Mm-hmm.
Don't write them off.
True.
And we also, apart from that, pure tunakuanga tuna a lot of other mental issues.
Mm-hmm.
We have those ones when you wakona schizophrenia.
Mm-hmm.
We have so many other mental disorder. We have mood disorders. We have all of them.
Mm-hmm.
So we are also trying to bring a community, some speakers. Eh? So
mm-hmm.
as we go, si kila mahali na tumia the same topic. Eh?
Mm-hmm.
Unapata there some places, maybe as you go, unaenda na mtu mwenye ni psychologist.
Mm-hmm.
And wanamuuliza maswali, anawaambia.
Mm-hmm.
Wanamuuliza maswali. They can talk to the person privately,
mm-hmm.
which is so good. And we need it, by the way.
True.
You know, some things we normally say, ati ni uchawi, sijui nani alimroga, sijui alimfanya nini.
Yeah.
Like, you know, already I had believed that that we are a cursed generation.
Mm-hmm.
My mother, teen mother, my sister, so me, I said, me, I decided to use religion that was available. I prayed, I talked, no, I argued with God. That was not a prayer. That was a discussion he had with him. So he intervened in my case.
True.
Now, another person can also help intervene to another. Yeah. So sahi, Mr. Semati, ni uchawi. Pia ni decision. So hiyo kubreak circle ni kitu important sana.
True.
Yeah.
And so speaking of breaking the circle, yes. You said you also give brands to teenage mothers.
Yes.
And
yes.
You go to schools, talk to them. Do they come out? Because being a teen mom, it's a stigmatization in its own way. Like you feel so much stigmatized to just come out and say, I'm a teen mother and so I need a bra.
So what we are doing, we are thinking of first of all, mentoring teachers. We want to train teachers. Teachers, policemen. Teachers, policemen, ask me why. A policeman didn't handle case of defilement. Because wa wasichana wengi, utapata, we come to realize, it is not their classmates wengi they misuse them. Because if you make a child pregnant, that is, hiyo ni makosa.
True.
Hiyo ni makosa kabisa. So like we train police how they'll be handling them. Also we exchange notes. Ile department mtu akikuja anasaidiwa aje. Teachers also. We are going to organize. We have a teacher mwenye anajua. Nilikuwa na wasichana 20 in my class. They have come 15. Where are the rest of the 5? So ana reach out. So then who you peer also we are going to have. We have this project in Etwa. My sister's keeper, yeah, our boys. That one will be giving them boxers, eh? Because again, as you are talking
exactly, because as you're talking to the girls, it takes two to tango, as they usually
nice.
Say.
So, nice.
So you can't be talking to girls yet. For the girl to be pregnant, a boy has to be involved.
Yes. Now we are going to have this. My brother's keeper, my sister's keeper. Sorry, in that how watoto wengi. Wasichana we grow more than we grow earlier than the boys. So unapata mtu wa high school ndiye ame pregnant mtu wa primary or mwenye ako juu yake kidogo. So we want to make sure that we also want to reach to these two boys to ambie kuja ukiona mtu anaongelesha dada yako ama msichana stand waambie no, we are not going to do this.
Yes.
So talk out.
Yeah.
So alafu teachers alafu pia wakati mtu anaenda ku you know if get, boys ndio wana making fun sana wa wasichana. Me think it's boys who used to really make fun of me. Uko na machi kumbwa. But you know the only thing that I used to beat them, I used to be bright.
Yes.
So I'm number one in that class.
Despite the fact that you have a big
so
butt.
So you tell me, number one. And I'm like, but with the time, it got into me. Wakati adolescence na kuingia. Oh, by the way. Ha! Enyewe. So inferiority complex comes in. But yes. Before, but all the same. Because I was a bit vocal, also I was vocal, I was bright in a way. I used to do a lot of poetry. I used to vent na poetry sana. So I was all over. But ni later man niko footballer.
Then what happened?
How can I? Because you feel like you are nini.
You're harassing something.
Yeah,
kind.
I love your nini is hurting. Your back is hurting. So you imagine the pow in like. So my dream died.
Sorry. But you live to fight another day.
For some
day.
Reason, I don't like football in real life. Why? I don't know any football. I don't see why. Like all these men will run over one ball. Everybody should have theirs. So it was a defense mechanism I formed to make myself look good after that. Yeah.
So, teenage pregnancy.
Yeah.
You're giving out bra to girls. You said you're giving boxers to boys.
Yes.
And teenage pregnancy, you will start to. And teenage pregnancy is just not a menace that is going away anytime soon. There are so many people involved. You talk of border menace. You find that these girls are going, like for example, during lunch hour, they are going out to look for food. Not each and every student or pupil will afford to buy food or carry food from home. They are going out there. They are being lured into so much things because of, into sex to be specific, because of poverty. So what are you, there are girls who are even having sex because of lack of pads. So what are you doing towards that?
You know, it would have been, ingekuwa ni kama story, kama ni ukweli, if I will not, I almost experienced it. Mm-hmm. Because you can imagine, hauna hata sabuni, mm-hmm. hauna hata mafuta, mm-hmm. hauna hata nguo ya kuvaa. Mm-hmm. During those time, we used to wear kamisi. Mm-hmm. Yeah, those ones. I used to love a green one. Anyway. So, we call it in our language, green majani. Mm-hmm. So, I could look at it this way. Mm-hmm. Kama si watu walinifaitia. You know, this thing is true.
Yeah.
You are seated here, maybe, kwanza hawa nyonaka, who don't have parents. Actually, mm-hmm. hawa sichana, ukinembia when how I'm mapping out,
mm-hmm.
child-headed family. Mama amekufa, baba amekufa,
mm.
ama mama alikufa, baba akabaki. Mm. No, normally, unapata, wewe unaanza ku assume role ya parent in a way.
Mm.
So, lazima utalak. Na kama mimi, maybe God alinitumia watu, a community can raise.
Mm.
But in that community, me, I was raised in Western region.
Mm-hmm.
And I come from Kisii. But these people, they owned me.
Mm-hmm.
Up to now, they usually say mtoto wetu.
Mm-hmm.
Because I was raised by the community.
Mm-hmm.
Now, our watu, I know I'll not be able to do everything
yeah.
at a time.
Yeah.
But I know now that I've started this project,
mm-hmm.
we'll go, it's a foundation,
mm-hmm.
we will go nationwide, mm-hmm. internationalwide. This is a project that, this project will live after me.
True.
It will live after me and the generation to come.
Yeah.
And I'm sure as this, like a small step to meanza,
mm-hmm.
to itaguza a few.
Yeah.
Na ikikuza a few, like, there will be other roses.
Yeah.
Other roses will come.
Yeah.
Other roses will crop up.
Yeah.
You never know in the next 20, 30 years what will happen.
Mm-hmm.
So, to Nikonaila projection, yeah, we'll have other roses.
Mm-hmm.
They will be better than me.
Mm-hmm.
They'll have better ideas.
Mm-hmm.
They reach others.
Mm-hmm.
But as it is now, tunajua teen pregnancy,
mm-hmm.
iko. Na iko, wana nambio kuna place ngino koko senya niko rampant vibaya sana.
Vibaya sana.
Yes.
And it's a menace that is not going away anytime
yes.
soon.
Yes.
But with people like you who are trying to put one, two together to just make sure that it dies with time,
yes.
we celebrate you. And I want you to look into that camera and just encourage young girls who are watching you. Tell them a word of confidence and just give them an advice.
Before that,
uh-huh.
we are going to involve the cancer, the breast cancer ladies. Eh?
Mm-hmm.
I told you,
mm-hmm.
but then now we are going to have them from October. So we'll be also donating. We'll be bringing them those ones living this
mm-hmm.
in the slums. Eh?
Yeah.
So they also benefit. So bright will be for everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Now, for a girl who is out there, if you've given birth, you are not written off. You are not. Wasikuite mtumba. Don't get married to a man you didn't want. Don't. You deserve a second chance. We all make mistake. Mistake is normal. Alaf, if you have like big breasts like me, like now at least I'm manageable because my body is it's something like that. Know that you're not the only one. And we have so many types of nini. And if you are maybe an orphan, you don't know utaishi aje, how you're going to manage yourself from where you are. Look at me. This is Rose. Rose didn't have anything, but the community fought for her. So, if you can always reach me, if I have a page where one girl, one bra on Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
So, if there's a need, unataka usaidiwe, or you'd like to reach to somebody, you can reach to me, because I have other friends. We are a community. You are not alone. In short, you're not alone. And if help reaches you, be another Rose. I really would wish that in the next 20, 30 years, we have so many roses, main roses sprout. Na hii culture ya teen pregnancy, we break that cycle with time.
Okay.
And you are the best, by the way.
Okay.
You're wonderful.
Okay. So
yes.
We celebrate you, Rose, and keep doing what you're doing.
Thank you. Keep encouraging
those girls, keep motivating them. And to the girls who are watching us this morning, if you have a big bust, know that the best accessory that a woman can ever wear is confidence. I've been your host, Faith Msoli. Up next is Kayesu. Stay tuned with Girls Talk.